Dear learners, Namaskar. I, Naipal Singh, welcome you to the program of Library and Information Science at Senior Secondary level. In the last program, we presented an overview of information sources. The topic of our today's program is Types of Information Source, in which we shall discuss different types of information sources. Broadly, there are four types of information sources which we told you in the last program. They are primary sources, secondary sources, tertiary sources, electronic sources. First of all, we shall discuss primary source of information. As you know that primary sources are those sources which contain original information. These include new raw data, new interpretation of previously known facts or idea, any new observation or experiment. Primary sources include periodicals, newspapers, technical reports, dissertation, conference paper, patents, standards, trade and product bulletins. First of all, we take periodicals. What is periodical? A periodical is a publication which is published with definite periodicity, that is weekly, fortnightly, monthly or quarterly under the same title and intended to be brought out indefinitely. Each issue is dated as consecutively numbered. All the issues in a volume have continuous pagination. A periodical consists of collection of articles contributed by different authors. Periodicals are also called journals. There are many types of periodicals such as scholarly periodicals, trade and business periodicals, popular periodicals, magazines, and e-journals, newspapers. Let us talk about scholarly periodicals. Scholarly periodicals are published by learned societies, R&D organizations, universities, and some reputed commercial publishers. These are better known as journals, which generally publish research findings and are peer-reviewed. Because of rigorous evaluation process, these publications are also referred as refereed or peer-reviewed journals. Each article in such journals becomes a permanent record of that subject. The purpose of a scholarly peer journal is to report original and significant research in a particular discipline. Articles in these journals are written by researchers, professionals, or experts in the field. The articles are mostly technical in nature and cannot be understood by readers who lack the subject background. Normally, these journals do not carry any advertisement. Example of this type of journal is Indian Journal of Experimental Biology. The second type of journals are trade and business periodicals. Trade and business periodicals are published by trade organization and commercial publisher. These periodicals cover articles, news, trends and issues for specific business and industry. Authors of articles in these journals can be professional in the field of journalist working for the publisher. Example of trade and business periodicals are Indian Textile Journal, Chemical Week. Now we come to popular periodicals. What are popular periodicals? Popular periodicals are devoted to particular subject area and contain articles written in simple language. These periodicals are meant for general public who do not have specialized knowledge of a particular subject. These are published to inform, educate and entertain the public. Example of popular periodical is Science Reporter, which is normally published in English, but it is also published in Hindi and Urdu. Now we come to magazines. The magazines are published by newspaper and commercial publisher. Content of the magazine include information on a popular personalities, news and general interest. Articles. Author in magazine are journalist and freelance writer. Language is simple and designed to meet minimum education level. Each issue begins with page number 1. The example of magazine are India Today, Filmfare, Business Today. Let us now take e-journal. E-journal are produced, published and distributed nationally or internationally via electronic network. E-journals are also known as paperless journal and online journals. E-journals on CD-ROM is like having printed journal in a library. However, it requires computer and software to read. It has many advantages over print journal. CD-ROM with its storage capacity of over 250,000 pages can provide full text of individual or collected journal of various subject. Online journals or e-journals on the internet can be accessed remotely at any time and from anywhere. Example of e-journals is Advance in Natural Science, International Journal of Human Sciences. Now we come to the newspaper. Newspaper publishes news of recent happening on political, social and economic issue of a nation or a region. These are published daily or bi-weekly. Coverage in newspaper includes news, current events, advertising and topics of human interest. There are different kinds of newspaper. Some newspaper specialize in economic and financial matter and bring out depth analysis of trade, banking, commerce. For example, Economics Times is this type of newspaper. Example of other newspapers are Times of India, Hindustan Times, Navbharat Times, etc. Now we shall discuss the primary source of information other than periodicals. These are technical reports, conference papers, dissertation and thesis, patents, standards, trade and product bulletins. Let us know what are technical reports. Technical reports are research reports which are published after conducting research and mostly in the field of science and technology. Such research is usually sponsored by government organizations, industries or other agencies. The researcher who conduct research for sponsoring body write research result in the form of technical report and submit to the sponsoring agency. Let us now discuss conference paper or conference proceeding. A conference is a gathering, meeting sponsored or organized by a learned body, where information is exchanged or discussed by expert in a particular subject or field. After the conference proceedings are published, which contain the papers presented in the conference along with discussion, minutes of the meeting and resolution adopted. Now we come to the dissertation and thesis. Dissertation or thesis is a document which is submitted by a researcher in support of candidature for a degree or professional qualification. In most of the universities, dissertation is submitted at the end of one's master's degree and thesis is submitted at the end of PhD. The example of thesis is digital light photography, a thesis submitted to the Department of Computer Science, University of Delhi for award of doctorate degree. Let us discuss patents. Patent is a government grant which gives a person or a company sole right to make, use or sell a new invention, product, process or a design for a certain number of years. Individual and companies engaged in R&D activities protect their invention by patenting them with the government. The government grants the patent and publishes the detail of granted patents through an official publication. Indian patents are published in Gazette of India, Part 3 and Section 2. Now we come to standards. Standard is a document which provides requirement specification, guidelines or characteristics that can be used consistently to ensure that material, products, processes and services are fit for the required purpose. Thus, a standard is a set of rules for ensuring quality of a product, a process or a service. Standards are basically of two types: fundamental standards and technical standards. Let us now discuss trade and product bulletins. Trade and product bulletins are information products brought out by the publisher, manufacturers and distributor of various types of materials, products or services. trade and product bulletins cover every kind of material, product or services such as books, drugs, chemicals, household goods to complex machinery and equipment used in research and industry. The basic purpose of this type of trade literature is to describe various attributes to the product, material or service and promote its sale to potential customer. Now we shall discuss the secondary source of information. Secondary sources. Information published in primary sources on a particular subject is widely scattered and is available in large number of primary sources, which we have already discussed in today's program. In addition, the research results are published in different languages. This scattered information is compiled and published in the form of secondary sources of information. These are secondary periodicals, bibliographies, books, reviews, treatises, state of art, reports, reference sources, etc. Secondary periodicals. Secondary periodicals are those periodicals which regularly scan the literature published in the primary sources and select the relevant item and bring them to the notice of researcher at weekly, fortnightly or monthly interval. These publications contain bibliographical reference of each item with or without abstract. Indexing periodicals. In indexing periodical, the relevant item with full bibliographical details are selected from primary sources and arranged either under broad subject heading or under class numbers. This arrangement brings all the items on the same subject together. Bibliographical details help the reader to identify and locate the original document. Example of an indexing periodical is The Reader's Guide to Periodical Literature. It covers recently published article in 400 scholarly journal and popular magazine in a wide range of subject. Now we come to abstracting periodicals. In an abstracting periodical, the content of the selected items are condensed or summarized along with the bibliographical detail of the document, which help the reader to identify and locate the original document. The abstract of the article helps the user to decide whether to read the full document or not. Example of abstracting periodical is Indian Science Abstract, which is fortnightly abstracting periodicals reporting the scientific research work done in India and published in Indian journals. Bibliographies. A bibliography is a systematic list of documents that share a common factor that may be subject, a language, a period, an author, or some other criteria. The list is arranged by some order. Such bibliography known as enumerative or systematic bibliography attempts to record or list. Each entry provides bibliographical detail of the document, like entry of the book may contain information on name of the author, title of the book, publisher and date of publication. An entry of journal may contain name of the author, article title, journal title, volume number, issue number and year of publication, page number, etc. Now we come to national bibliography. What is national bibliography? A national bibliography lists the publication produced in a country. For example, in India we have Indian National Bibliography. Trade bibliography. Trade bibliographies are brought out by the publisher, bookseller, distributor or printer. These bibliographies list books which are meant for sale. Trade bibliographies are used by the libraries to select books for the library. Example of trade bibliography is Indian Books in Print. Now we come to subject bibliography. A subject bibliography lists the document on a given subject. To carry out literature search and compile a subject bibliography is one of the important services of a library. Sometimes these bibliographies are compiled on regular basis in anticipation of the user needs. These bibliographies are also compiled on special occasion, such as during the seminar and workshops, to provide the participant with the latest literature on the subject. Universities and special libraries offer this service more frequently than the public library. Example of subject bibliography is a subject bibliography of the First World War books in English. Now we come to books. What is book? A book can be broadly defined as a written or published document of at least 49 text pages that communicate thoughts, ideas or information. Pages of the books are glued or sewn together along one side, called the spine or back, so that it can be opened at any point. Two covers of the books are joined by hinges to the spine. Books are either hardbound or softbound depending on the cover. Most of the hardbound books have a cover made of cloth, plastic or leather over cardboard. A paper cover jacket is often added to protect cover of the hardbound book. Most of the softbound books called paperbacks have paper covers. There are pamphlets and manuscripts also, which are different from books. Let us know what is pamphlet. A pamphlet is an unbound printed publication with no cover or with paper cover. It may consist a minimum of 5 pages and maximum of 48 pages exclusive of the cover page. Manuscript. Manuscript is a term used for the document written or typed by a machine such as typewriter or computer. The word is often used to distinguish an author's original version of a work, which may be book, an article, or any other work, from the printed copy. In addition, manuscripts refer to any handwritten document from ancient time until the introduction of printing in 1400 centuries. Such manuscripts are called historical manuscripts. Most historical manuscripts can be traced to the certain times or areas by the material on which they were written. Now we come to books type. Books are important source of information and libraries acquire them based on the need of the user. Based on the content, a book may be a simple book or a composite book, single volume book or multi-volume book, fiction book or non-fiction book, a textbook or a treatise. Based on the physical format, a book may be in print or non-print medium. Books in non-print medium include audio books, video books, multimedia books and e-books. Let us now discuss reference book. What is reference book? A reference book provides answer to brief facts, statistical information, background information, or directs you to additional information source. It is a book meant only to be consulted or referred to for some specific piece of information, and this is not meant for continuous reading. Reference books include dictionaries, encyclopedias, handbook, yearbook, almanacs, directories, biographical and geographical sources. Examples are the Oxford Dictionary of Quotation, Word Book Encyclopedia, the Statesman Yearbook, the Word Book Atlas, etc. Now we come to the tertiary source of information. Tertiary sources are based on primary and secondary sources of information and serves as key to the primary and secondary sources. These sources are usually compilation from primary or secondary sources. These publications do not carry subject information, but they guide to the user to the source where information on that subject will be available. Under tertiary source of information come publications like Guide to Literature, Guides to Reference Sources, Bibliography of Bibliographies, etc. Some of the examples are Bibliographic Index, a cumulative bibliography of bibliographies, Wolfert Guide to Reference Material. Let us come to now electronic sources. What are electronic sources? Electronic sources are those publications for which we require a computer to access the information they contain. Electronic publication can be offline or online. Offline electronic publication is the publication which is stored in machine-readable form or in electronic storage medium like CD-ROM, DVD, diskette or magnetic tape, etc., and which can be accessed using computer and software. Online electronic publication is an electronic document which is accessible online on the internet, for example, an electronic journal, a worldwide page or online databases. Most of the sources we have discussed today program are available in both print and electronic form, but some of the sources which were in print form earlier are now available in electronic form only. For example, Library and Information Science Abstract and Guide to Reference Books are published and distributed electronically only. The advantage and limitation of electronic sources over print sources are: electronic sources are more frequently updated than their print counterpart. Electronic sources provide more search options. They provide access to wider range of information. They provide faster and easy access to information, particularly in the case of indexing and abstracting periodicals, where back volumes are consolidated into single searchable database. Search is easy and extremely fast in electronic resources. Online resources provide linkage from citation to full-text e-journals. Full-text data can be delivered instantly on the remote computer. Electronic resources can be delivered in a multimedia format where text, video, and sound can be added. A print source can be used by one person at a time, where an online electronic source can be accessed simultaneously by many users. An online electronic source can be accessed at any time and from any place where network exists. Back volume of print periodicals need to be bound and stored. This calls for lots of expenses and plenty of storage space. Where e-journals are accessible online, they need not be bound or stored. Even electronic resources on CD-ROMs occupy very little space. Missing issues, missing pages, and other damages caused by mishandling of print sources do not occur in electronic sources. There are some limitations also of electronic sources, which are: use of electronic sources require expensive infrastructure which must be acquired, maintained and upgraded. This includes computer hardware and software, internet connection and subscription to electronic resources. Electronic resources, despite being user-friendly, require certain degree of computer knowledge to get maximum benefit from them. This means libraries have to incur expenses to train their staff as well as the user to use the resources. Most of the publisher of e-publication sell their product under license agreement. The license agreement imposes a number of restrictions on the user in the use of e-resources. Reading from the computer screen causes discomfort to the user. Most of the user prefers to take printout of the article for reading and do most of the reading from the print publication only. Though advantage of electronic sources are far more than their limitation, but they are not likely to replace print sources in the future. People still prefer to read newspaper, books and many other sources in print form. Thus, electronic sources will not substitute but supplement print sources. Dear learner, we have discussed in today's program different types of information sources, that is primary, secondary, tertiary and electronic sources. I hope that today's program will be helpful to you to understand better the different types of information sources. Thanks for watching this program. We shall meet in next program with another topic. Thank you, learners.